As African nations move ahead economically, the demand for power is increasing enormously across the continent. What's been done about it, and how are the projects that are being proposed or underway being financed? Well, Maree Roos is an associate of Cresco Project Finance. This is a financial advisory firm assisting with the development of projects through to a bankable stage. Maree, thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much, Jeremy.
You've been looking specifically at the southern African power markets, that is a dozen or so countries below Democratic Republic of Congo and Tanzania, or should I say south of. What are your thoughts?
Well, it's an interesting question. First of all, you are right. I mean, we have seen substantial growth in these countries, especially in the economic activity as well as the electricity demand in these countries over the last couple of years have been fairly robust. Despite the economic turmoil in the rest of the world, these countries have undergone major economic growth. And our projection is, and our belief is, that these countries will keep on growing in the next foreseeable future.
Is there an appreciation, do you think, that of the power that's needed across the region? Do you think people really appreciate just how much there is going to have to be provided? I mean, what's your view of the demand side?
I would say it varies. If you speak to the people in the know, I think there is a good appreciation that there's a big need for major investments in the electricity industry, not only in the power generation sector, but also in the transmission and distribution sector. You know, as the economy is growing, we need to make sure that the electricity sector keeps pace and are able to support those economic growth and activities. And as such, I think there is an appreciation about the size of investments that are needed, as well as the scale of investments that are needed. However, I think more work needs to be done. We need to spread the message, not only in Southern Africa, but we need to take this message forward to countries around the world that are interested in making investments in Southern Africa.
It seems to me that Mozambique is particularly interested, or the government there is particularly interested in this. Why is that?
It's a good point, because I think, you know, Mozambique is quite unique. Mozambique has got a number of very interesting dynamics coming into play at the moment. First of all, Mozambique sits on fairly substantial hydro potential, which will enable them to build large hydropower stations that will be able to power their industry. But on top of that, they also have fantastic coal resources. And more recently, they've made substantial natural gas discoveries. These three energy forms in the short, medium, and long term will push the economic development in Mozambique as well as in Southern Africa forward in a substantial and meaningful way.
What about the interconnections between the different countries in Southern Africa? How good are they? How easily able are they to export power?
Yeah, look, at the moment there is no doubt that the number of interconnections are not enough, and that they are weak. We certainly, as a region, need to strengthen those interconnections. I mean, if you can imagine a spider's web, that there is complete interconnection between the different countries, that is what we should aspire towards. At the moment, we don't have that. And as a result, major investments are needed. And utilities as well as governments will have to play a substantial role in making sure that the policy, regulatory, and legal environments are conducive towards these investments that are needed.
Well, you use the word investment. Who's the funding behind all this? Who's going to provide the money?
Look, given the scale of investments that are needed, I don't think there's only one institution. I think the answer lies in a combination of investments. We're looking at public investments. Of course, utilities as well as governments will have to step in. They will have to come up and play a meaningful role in investments. But that would not be enough. We also need private investments and major private investments in the form of power generation as well as transmission lines to make sure that the necessary infrastructure are developed and are put in place so that the people can benefit from the gains of having access to low-cost and reliable electricity.
If you're bringing in the private sector, there's got to be a profit in it. What about price projections? Is it going to be able to sustain a profit?
It's an interesting point, because at the moment prices in Southern Africa are generally low, and I think most of the utilities as well as the government are working towards rebalancing those tariffs and charges to make sure that they reflect the cost of supply and that they will be able to sustain ongoing future investments. But it's a slow process, because it can't be done overnight. It will have to be done and according to a plan. So I think there is realization, and if you speak to most of the utilities and the governments, there is also an appreciation that needs to be done. But it is a question that they have to step it up, otherwise the investments won't be sustainable. So the profit motive is there, it's appreciated, but I think, tariffs will have to be adjusted to compensate for that.
Very interesting. Okay, Maree Roos, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you very much, Jeremy.